Oh my god, I'm gonna die. Fuck, I wish I told my dad that I loved him.
You see what death does, William? Focuses.
Roger!
I just don't understand.
You are James, and you are the other.
Would you sleep with me? Just sleep. I just need someone.
Samson, beautiful man.
Guilt. We all feel it. When you make up some lame excuse not to meet your friend for lunch. When you tell your mum to stop buying clothes for you because her taste is just wrong. Or when you hit your kids. Or when someone dies and you never told them that you love them. Guilt presses down on you, smothers you, like you can't breathe. The Insider's Guide to Happiness, Chapter 6. Do you deserve to be happy?
I guess I'm cured.
You have a metastatic brain tumour. Cancer in your colon has spread to your lung and is now in your
brain. Now in my brain. How long I got, Doc?
It's your file.
Have you done your list?
You?
Just wrote my number 3.
Will it almost kill me like your number 2 did?
No, well, maybe.
What is it?
No, we're not doing mine today, we're doing yours. So what's first?
Okay.
It's important to me that you know something before you go.
You mean die? Carry on.
I love you. There.
Oh,
Oh, you need a new number one, mate.
Stop. Stop laughing.
I know exactly what it should be.
You can't rewrite my list.
Oh, let's get out of here.
Nothing.
He's not there.
My astral guide says no.
Tess, I'm right here.
There's a chance that he hasn't crossed over yet.
Wait. Ask him to try again.
If he makes contact, what do you want me to ask him?
Was he going to meet me?
That's all I could think about. Tell her! Wait. So, what else can I expect to happen to me?
It's not usual to speak during meditation.
Right. I keep forgetting. Sorry.
Can I read people's minds?
I knew you were going to say that. Seriously, though, that whole speaking to the dead thing, is that for real? What if that's something I don't want? You know, can I just not do it?
You wish to continue denying your powers?
Oh, that's pretty freaky, you know? Dead people.
It depends on how you look at it. It can be freaky, or it can be useful. Say someone is hurting over not telling a friend something important before the friend died. You can ease their pain.
Yeah, that'd be okay. That'd be kind of cool.
You sure you won't come in?
No, I'm late already.
Okay. Thanks for rescuing me.
Tina?
What?
Are you going to be okay?
I'll be fine. Dad, I need to pee.
Okay, mate. Just do it over the side, eh? Good boy! That's it. Pull it back now. Wind it in. Reel it. You okay?
I pee my pants.
Don't. Stop it. The only reason I'm doing this is because you're dying.
It'll be fun. Be like old times, you guys and me.
Fun?
Yes, fun. What's your problem? You don't like fun anymore.
When I saw her last week, she said she forgives me.
So, isn't forgiveness a good thing?
Her forgive me.
Oh, you think she's the one who needs to be forgiven?
Well, don't you?
Forgiven for what?
For leaving like she did, for just giving up.
So she's the only one who gave up. Look, if it goes badly, just tell her I've got cancer. She'll cry and you can say, it's okay, baby, it's okay.
I'm not saying that.
She'll think you're the great guy that you always were and I'll feel better.
About what?
Nothing.
I could...
run with me. He's dead. Let it go. And stop talking to yourself.
It's okay. I'll find a way to get through to you.
Mum has no idea what family is. You're meant to be there for your kids, like I will be.
And Tim?
Tim? I hardly know him.
Well, you know him well enough to get him these.
I just like having him around, that's all. He makes me laugh.
What's that?
I don't know.
Now, don't be surprised if she doesn't show.
She'll be here.
I'm just saying, she's not exactly reliable.
We talking about the same person here?
Well, maybe she backed out because of me.
Actually, she doesn't know you're here.
You didn't tell her?
No, I think she'd back out. What's interesting, though, is you knew about her, but you decided to come anyway. Now, why is that, William?
This was a bad idea.
Hey, what's wrong?
She hates surprises.
Surprise.
It's called a fair fight.
A fair fight, like foxy boxing?
No. It's about not giving up on something that matters to you, confronting an issue, and hopefully moving on.
And you do this with a straight face?
And why would I find it funny?
Well, you've never given up on something that matters.
Like what?
Dunno. Relationship?
I thought we were going to reminisce about the old days.
We are.
Come on, stop it. They were good times. We were happy then.
Oh, we're not happy now.
I'm happy.
You're right.
Happier than you.
Oh, God, this really is like the old days. You two bitching on and me bored as fuck.
It's nice, isn't it? There's only one thing that's missing. Humour me.
Well, listen.
You're running off.
I've got a show to make.
Yeah, okay, we've only just got started.
Can't, I'm late. Well, see ya.
I've got cancer. I'm kidding, I was just kidding. I just wanted you to stay longer, go. Be famous, make us proud, Lindy Lou.
Does he have cancer?
Apparently not.
Nice one, Phil.
What's wrong with you?
Me?
You let her go.
She doesn't need to know you're dying.
When are you going to stop doing this?
What?
Letting her go.
No, don't.
All right, well, what's number two on your list?
It's for ruining my life.
Is this the new high? How are you?
An ex-girlfriend of mine wanted to spend some time with me this morning. Mm-hmm. And I said no, and now I feel guilty.
And how is that my fault?
Because you said I was good and kind and nice.
You've lost me.
I'm none of those things. I'm like the unnicest guy I know. And now I feel...
nice?
Yes. You know, like I don't want to hurt her or something.
You know what's happening, don't you?
I'm possessed.
You're listening to your conscience.
Oh, I thought I got rid of that.
This is nice. It's a nice thing to do. When did you last go fishing?
I was 10.
Yeah, you catch anything?
Dad?
We're gonna have to kill it.
Dad said it was the biggest fish he'd ever seen.
Never caught a fish.
Yeah. Well, maybe today you'll get lucky.
Me? Lucky?
Or you just say, I wish for a big fat fish.
Come on, William. You don't really believe that.
Yeah, I do.
You know as well as I do that I've always been the loser.
What?
I dropped out of med school. You're a brilliant doctor. I never caught a fish. You caught the biggest fish your dad had ever seen. You got Lindy, I got nothing. Do you remember when I threw your Monopoly board out the window?
No.
Do you know why I did it?
I had more hotels than you?
Yes. I tried so hard to beat you, but you still won. And I knew then that you'd always be a winner. And that's what I want to remember. William the winner, not this. I wanted to be like you. I didn't think you'd end up like me.
Phil? Phil, mate. You alright? I'm gonna get you a shawl, mate.
And then I collapsed. And Sam took me to the hospital. So good to me. Tina, what kind of drugs do you take? The usual kind. E, some acid.
Is that all?
No. Tina, what's going on?
You never used to take drugs and now you're like doing everything. What's up with that?
I think I'm being punished.
Punished for what?
Jesus. I was just lying there under cash. 6.3 million. Less bills. A red sports car and $1 million.
$1 million?
I'm not a very good gambler. So what do you think I should do?
You really believe this is some kind of karma thing?
Sam left the day I found the ticket. Who knows what'll happen to me next?
If you think it's ruining your life, get rid of it.
But don't you think Sam leaving was good karma?
Is that work related?
What do you want?
Favour. I need you to contact someone.
Me? Why?
Well, you're kind of the only one that can do it.
Right. So this someone, are they on the other side?
You could say that.
Who told you to come to me? Or was it the young one or the old one?
Eh?
Of course. I'd be glad to help.
Hey, that's what I'm here for.
Meet me after work.
Feeling okay, James?
Yeah, fine. Thanks for asking.
So what was that all about? Some kind of role-playing exercise?
What? Oh, right, no. He's a client. Yeah, need some help.
Smiling about?
Just thinking about the past.
Your past or the past in a more general historic sense? Got another corporate greed story. Thought you might be interested.
Have you ever been skinny dipping?
No. I have a deeply rooted body shame.
I used to skinny dip. With my boyfriend. He gave me that.
I assume it wasn't broken then?
No, it was perfect.
Read it. Then talk to me. I DJ, that I like.
So why karaoke?
Money, I guess. Don't we all do things that make us unhappy? For whatever reason?
Well, yeah, I hate my job too.
Yeah. The thing is, you've got to find balance. You've got to counter the unhappiness with things you enjoy.
Like fucking.
Yeah, that'd do it.
Hey, thank you for this.
I guess it's part of my life now. We'll do it at my place. The monks might be able to help.
Monks?
Yeah, they know all about this stuff.
James, all I need is a message written down and delivered to Tess.
Same chick as last time?
Yeah.
How's she on the other side?
She's not.
Okay, look, I thought... Why can't you do this yourself?
Because I'm, you know, yeah, no, you're right. There's no reason I can't do this myself.
There you go. Well, later.
This was on the fridge.
I wanted you to find it.
It's an ambulance crash.
It's your ambulance crash. It's Simon.
Tim, why would you draw something like this?
I drew this a week before Simon died. It's a picture of a dream I had.
You dreamed this?
I do that sometimes. I dream the future. If I'd known it was you, I would have warned you. But you're okay. Both of you. You think I'm crazy, don't you?
No, why would I think that? I just don't want it on my fridge.
Just three to go.
What?
Your list. You've done one and two. Show me what your number three is. I like it. Promise me you'll do it.
Okay. So, what's the last thing on your list?
I can do this.
Yes, you can. Don't you already just keep doing what you're doing?
Oh, God. I can't. Sorry.
Bullshit.
You're making it up.
William, it's true. It happened. Just once. I think.
You think?
We may have done it two times on the same night. Does that count as once or twice?
Twice?
Yeah, well, it was a mistake. We were drunk. And if it's any consolation, I was thinking about you the whole time. I'm sorry.
So this is why you came back, to tell me that?
It's one reason I came back. It's not the reason.
Oh, so what is? Jesus Christ!
I always wanted to fuck you, not Lindy.
Oh, fuck, what?
Still, she was okay. Yeah, I was only kidding. Just a joke. God, look at your face.
Oh.
Except the Lindy stuff, you know? That's all true.
I could so kill you right now.
Oh. What are you doing?
I'm unplugging your life support.
I'm on life support?
Yep.
Hey! What is that plug?
No idea.
Maybe you should sleep on the couch tonight.
No.
Wait, look, stop, stop. Hey, listen, look, there's a reason I can't do this myself. Look, and it'll explain everything.
Okay.
I'm not real.
You're not real.
Look, you're the only one who can see me because I'm dead. You know, the guy in the newspaper, that wasn't my cousin, that was me.
Prove it.
Ask this guy if he can see me.
Mr. Dixon, can you see a Samoan guy standing next to me?
James, what are you doing?
You can't see him, can you? Say something.
I'm right here.
Did you hear that? He said I'm right here. Is there something you want to talk about, James?
No, no, I'm fine. Hey, just a survey. Thanks for helping out. Thank you. No one else can see you. Just me.
Just you.
Which is why you need my help.
Exactly.
Okay then. So what can I do for you?
You'll help me?
Hey. Will it ease your pain?
Yeah.
Of course I'll help you.
Hey, listen, let's find somewhere else so you don't look like you've got an imaginary friend, eh?
Right. Good one. Yeah, come on.
Hi.
Hi.
Can I come in?
Yeah, of course. Would you like a coffee? I was just gonna make one.
Sure, yeah, why not? Look, I just wanted to apologise about yesterday.
Apologise for what?
I should have stayed with you longer.
Oh, that's okay.
Yeah, I just, you know, I felt bad.
Sam, I'm okay.
Hey, do you think we did the right thing?
What do you mean?
Breaking up.
Well, maybe it was the right thing then.
Yeah. And what about now?
Maybe. Maybe now it's different. What are you saying to him? I'll make the coffee. There's some mail for you on the table. Something to eat?
$6 million.
Sam?
No. Thanks.
How long can you stay?
Actually, I think I should go.
Hey, Sam, it's okay. We can just talk.
Are you sure?
Yeah, if that's what you want.
Okay. Yes, I would like that.
I cheated. When I passed go, I'd collect 300 instead of 200 so I could buy the expensive properties. I wasn't the winner, Phil. I just didn't want to be the loser. I have to let you go now. When you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. When you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. When you're happy and you know it, and you really want to show it. If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands.
But he said he was joking.
Bad joke.
Take a seat.
Are you Tess?
Yeah.
I've got an important message for you.
Important?
It's from Matthew.
I'll be right back. Matthew Pulley.
Is that his last name?
Matthew's dead. Is this a joke?
I hope not. Or otherwise I'm completely wacko. I know he's dead. I've been in contact with him.
Okay, what's the message?
He was going to meet you.
Did that medium put you up to this?
No, I'm here because I can help.
Okay, what time is he going to meet me?
7. Monday last week, outside your place.
Okay, but he could have told you that before.
You wrote it in your diary. Next to his name. Is that right? He said that seeing you again was all he could think about. And that it's okay to talk to yourself in the mirror.
Show your love, yes it is, it's so easy.
I'm at the boat shed. Just wondering if you wanted to join me. Hi.
Hi.
Thanks for coming.
I wanted to.
Phil had three things he wanted to do before he died. Deliver a baby, fly a plane, which he did. But I think number three was the most important to him.
What was it?
To see you again. He made me do a list as well.
Really? What was it?
Well, the first two were done. I was hoping you'd help me with number three.
Depends on what it is.
Well, it'll just be for old time's sake. And because I promised Phil.
William, what is it?
Guilt. It's how you punish yourself if no one else will. You don't deserve to be happy because you've done a bad thing. Now, you can spend your life in that place, or you can forgive yourself. The great thing about guilt is that getting rid of it can be an uplifting experience. Like catching your breath.
Your funeral.
I'm coming!
You can see me!
I won't lose you, mate! Won't lose you!
Marriage is like a scrum. Put your head down and your bum up and you commit to it till it's over, no matter how horrible it is.
Was made with funding from New Zealand On Air.